Hello everyone, it's Nomad Flair here and welcome to another video. So today I'll be sharing my settings for the keyboard and mouse when playing the new Warzone Pacific map on console or on PC. So just a disclaimer guys, I have connected my keyboard and mouse to my PlayStation 5 and I do tend to switch up sometimes where I do play on controller and sometimes I decide to play on keyboard and mouse. So today's video is not targeting intermediate or advanced keyboard and mouse users, it's targeting beginners that don't know what type of keybinds to be using when starting off in Warzone. I have reviewed this keyboard on the channel, so if you do want to check it out, you can check my videos. And also, if you do want to pick one up, I will link it down in the description alongside the mouse as well, guys. So first things first, guys, just to let you know what keyboard and mouse I am using. I am using the Razer Viper Ultimate Mouse, which has 20,000 DPI, very, very fast. And I'm using the Keychron K2 version 2 mechanical keyboard, which I use as a gaming keyboard and office work keyboard. It's pretty much an all-round type of keyboard. Okay, so we've headed over to the options tab. Just make sure that your input device is keyboard and mouse and not on controller. If it is on controller, when you do end up diving into a Warzone game, okay, you'll notice that your keyboard and mouse will be completely inactive. It won't work at all. So do make sure that keyboard and mouse is highlighted first. Once that is done, head over to the keyboard and mouse bar. So the in-game mouse sensitivity, I've placed at 5.41, which works really well alongside a DPI of 2,400, which I use on my mouse. The great thing about this mouse, guys, is that I'm able to alter the DPI by pressing this button on the right-hand side. And I found that 3,200 is slightly too fast for me, so I've kept at 2,400. Okay, and then moving down to the advanced tab, I've kept everything on default, as you can see. Okay, you can fiddle around with this, entirely up to you, but I've kept at default and it works really well. So my ADS mouse sensitivity is on relative. I've tried legacy before and I just felt like it just didn't really work for me, to be honest. And then moving on to after zoom, again, I've kept everything on the default right here. The ADS sensitivity multiplier, I've reduced it from 1.0 to 0.96. And what this ultimately means is that when you are ADSing and you are moving to the left and to the right, trying to lock onto a target, it's not too fast that it hinders your accuracy. Okay, so I've slowed it down slightly and it allows me to be more accurate with my shots. Okay, and then scrolling further down, kept everything on default, just standards, and then 0, 0. And that's pretty much it for the mouse. Moving on to the movement, which is the big part of today's video. So my slide behavior, I kept it as a tap. You have two options between either a tap or hold. I prefer not to hold the button when sliding. Okay, I just prefer tapping it. Crouch behavior is toggle. So what toggle is basically you just press a button and you'll go into prone mode and you press the same button again and you'll exit from prone mode. And the same thing with crouch as well. The automatic airborne mantle, I've kept that as disabled. When sprinting or activating tactical sprint behavior, I kept that on toggle as well. Again, I don't want to be holding any of these buttons because that requires enough of my fingers. And then automatic sprint is disabled, which means you sprint automatically. That's going to be quite difficult, especially if you want to sneak up on an enemy. Walk behavior will be hold, and then a walk speed, I've kept it around a normal speed, which is 45%. There are several options such as 55%, which is slightly faster, and you've got, of course, 20%, 30, kept at 45. Parachute auto deploy, again, this is entirely up to you. I prefer to disable it, so I open it whenever I want. If I don't open it, I'll just land on my feet and die. All right, and then moving on to hold to use. So when open up a box, picking up a weapon, anything like that, okay, I don't want to be holding that, guys. So what will happen then? I just need to press a button and then I'm able to pick something up or open up a box, etc. So I just keep it as disabled. All right, and then in terms of moving forwards, to the left, to the right and back, okay, if you look at the keybinds, they're relatively close to one another. Forward is W, again, moving to the left will be A, moving to the right is D, and then moving backwards is S. To use, what that means is basically, again, to pick up a weapon, to open up a box, to open up a door. Okay, I've kept that as F, which is really close to, of course, me moving to the right, which is the D keybind. So F is right next to it alongside it. And as you can see, it's really, really close. I just press F and then it kind of allows me to interact with the surroundings. To jump, I have the space bar to jump. To crouch, I kind of made it easy for me to remember, C, crouch. And then to prone, which is right next to C on the right-hand side, is V. Moving on to the advanced tab, again, nothing right here, so we just collapse that. So moving down to sprint and tactical sprint and steady aim. So to sprint, I've assigned Q as the keybind. A tactical sprint, which means to sprint much faster, is the tab button, which is right next to Q. And then steady aim, so this is when, for example, you're using a marksman rifle or a sniper, something with, you know, a high zoom scope. I just assign that to the button right here on my mouse, which is the side button. Okay, and then if I wanted to walk and sneak, okay, it's the keybind right above, okay, the tactical sprint. Okay, so I kept everything relatively close to one another. Gesture and sprays, which to be honest, I never use, are spread out all the way along here, which is P. So again, that's totally fine. The rest is on default. Moving on to weapons and equipment. So depleted ammo weapon switch, I have that as enabled, which means as soon as all your ammo is depleted, it will then switch to your next weapon. Switch weapon minimum delay, kept it as 73. The only thing is that when you're using, for example, the mouse wheel and it's at a very high value, it can be very, very inconsistent, which means it might switch back and forth between your weapons at a very fast pace, and then that can mess up everything when in game. So switch, weapon switch wraparound is enabled. The rest of the weapons I've kept as the default. The weapon mount exit delay, kept on default as well. Aiming down the sight behavior. So when aiming down the sight, I will hold that, of course. I will not toggle. Scrolling down, okay, kept everything again on default. This is very important, which is the armor plate behavior. So instead of having it on apply one at a time, which means you have to keep on pressing the keybind assigned to your armor plate, okay, that will take a very long time. I just prefer to apply all of them all at once. So just press the button once, and then it will start to apply all of them at once. And again, the rest I've kept as default. Okay, moving on to the keybinds for my mouse at the moment. So to fire a weapon, okay, I have it as the left button on my mouse, and then to aim down the sight, I have it as the right button on my mouse. The advanced tab, I'm guessing that is nothing, yep. To reload, R reloads here right next to moving forward, so it's easy to remember. To switch to my next weapon, I press the two keybind, or I use the scroll wheel on my mouse. And then scrolling down to mount weapon, which I never do in Warzone, I've only done it in multiplayer. I kept that as Z. To alternate fire, so to change between fully automatic, semi-automatic, you're able to do that right here by pressing B. Again, something that I don't really do. I just go fully auto. To melee or to finish, perform a finishing move, okay, I kept that as E right here, which is in between the W and the R. To use a lethal, again, it's using the scroll wheel on my mouse. To use tactical, I use the side button, the top side button on my mouse. So to use an armor plate, I've assigned 4 to that. Night vision goggles, which I never use, but just in case, we have it as N, night vision. And to use a field upgrade, I have it as X right here. If I want to inspect my weapon, I just use the press I. The only reason I'll do that if I want to get an awesome thumbnail. To zoom in, have that as Y. To zoom out is J. And to change my loadout is the number 1. All right, guys, then moving on to kill streaks and vehicles. Twizz, the majority of this I kept as default. This is when, of course, flying a plane and when you're in a ground vehicle, etc. So it's very similar keybinds to on foot. So again, the same as W, S, A, D when moving forward to the left, etc. To fire, I did change this. I kept put that as basically the left button. To fire missiles, it's the scroll wheel, and to sound the horn, I've put as H, so I can remember that. It's very, very easy. To brake is space. To use the throttle, again, I'll scroll through this very, very quickly. This is the airplane keybinds. All right, the helicopter, again, kept as default as well. However, I did switch a few things, to be honest, was basically to ascend and to descend. And so to ascend, I want it to be on the left bottom of my mouse. To descend is the right. This makes it so much easier. So this initially has some random key bars assigned to it, and it just did not make sense, guys. So this made it so much easier for me. So I recommend doing the same thing, of course. And then lastly, moving on to overlays and shortcuts. So the scoreboard and everything like this kept on default. To show scores, I kept that as the caps lock. Show the map is M, easy to remember. To ping an enemy is left shift, so that would be right there for me. And then to open the inventory is the caps lock as well. And then again, if you want to mute anyone or adjust the sound, etc., again, you're able to do that, assign any of the keybinds. And then lastly, guys, moving on to the menu navigation. Again, I'll just leave that there for you guys to see. All right, everyone, so that was the settings for my keyboard and mouse when playing on console or on PC. I hope you found today's video to be useful. If you did, I would really appreciate if you could leave a like on the video to help support it, and also to subscribe to the channel as well. If there's any other videos you want to see on the channel, please let me know. Until next time, take care. It's not a game, it's a rage game.